Resuming our interview with Arturo Tafoyevsky. Trujillo, I looked at it, it did not make sense to me. Tafoyevsky, I recently baited Thomas and he sent me an email mocking me, saying bye-bye, that he got me kicked out of Twitter, or that I gave up. That was the first thing that tied up so many things. Here is the email that Thomas Schonberger sent to Arturo Tafoyevsky. Sukadilastat A858 email to Arturo blows his QO over May 20, 2019. As usual, I am reviewing many emails by Schonberger lately. The email is cryptic and dismissive. But as I write this commentary on August 11, 2019, I cannot help noticing that it can be interpreted as a prediction that presaged the deplatforming of 8chan. Schonberger, who claims to be the reincarnation of Saint Germain, flogs a reputation for himself as a fortune teller, a reputation that he mostly promotes himself using multiple sock accounts. And yet, Schonberger used the word Judas in threatening emails to Manuel Chavez III, and those of us keeping our fingers on the pulse of the so-called YouTube truther community know that Isaac Cappy called himself a Judas in his pre-suicide farewell. Tafoyevsky continues, that was the first thing that just tied up so many things. And I thought, this is the guy that Jerome Corsi was communicating and giving out information. I know that Thomas never did post. But remember, the things that he sells is his prophecies. He throws an arrow and where it hits is where he draws the bullseye. That is kind of how he makes his prophecies work. You can see repeated when he made his fake cicada on QAnon and on FBI Anon, also the patterns of FBI Anon, how it needed this channel Vitreous Libertas. Anyway, recently, a friend reported there is an associate who helps Thomas. Her name is Donna Emerald. She had a blog, and on her blog, she had posted that Jack was being contacted by someone who posted as Q and he was seducing her. We already knew that. That is Thomas's favorite target. Matrons, single, mature, more old ladies, who have a pension. Who can pay him? Tafoyevsky, you can see already the tweets that I made. That makes no sense at all. Then why, when the Corsi emails got leaked, nobody connected A858 to Pymobi and therefore to Thomas? And what about #FBI Anon? That is the same thing as Q, nor the #FakeCicada3301 connection. Like I said, I'm not saying DeFango did not help Thomas out. Trujillo, I am looking at his criminal history, his arrest for criminal felony stalking. Tafoyevsky, yes, you can say that he has a record on being a stalker. It invalidates many things that he does. Trujillo, nothing talks like a conviction. We need to be clear that an arrest is not a conviction. Tafoyevsky, like how he portrays his reputation. Trujillo, oh yeah. Absolutely. I am confused how you consolidated a connection between Jack and Q. Cubing's response to Q profiteering post-tweet response the 29th of April 2018. Tafoyevsky, like I said, you may have to. If you remember that era of QAnon, Patriot Soapbox every day, you had Jerome Corsi decoding Q, and Q called out Jerome Corsi and stuff. The profiteering drops. Q infamous Q profiteering drop the 29th of April 2018. Tafoyevsky, what I do have is evidence that Patriot Soapbox offered guests and privileges to their bigger monthly donors. It is also certain that Thomas lost control over his little creation. But it doesn't mean that he lost all his influence. Q Corsi profiteering Elami Fuentes. Tafoyevsky, and the fact that he infiltrated Jerome Corsi, and the thing is that Corsi offered that service of attaching people to that email. So it is kind of like a repeated scheme that Thomas does. He just leaves footprints everywhere. And also, Trujillo, everywhere. Tafoyevsky, patterns that he cannot escape from. Maybe this can answer your question better. I made the connection because when I searched the email that Thomas sent me, an A858 email, I searched it, it sent me to the Pymobi puzzle. The Pymobi puzzle is dismissed as an imitation cicada puzzle on the Uncovering Cicada wiki. They point to an archive from 4chan, and to Schonberger's YouTube channel Sophia Music, which displays nothing of immediate use, aside from a link to his blog. Trujillo, right. Tafoyevsky, that was Thomas's original puzzle. It showed me results of DeFango talking about the leaked emails between Q and Jerome Corsi. Trujillo, where are those leaked emails? Who has them? Tafoyevsky, well, DeFango put out a paste bin with links. Probably, you can say that it is decently documented. I can send it to you if you want. He did so, and so here it is. I cloned it for safekeeping here. Again, here is Chavez's post on Steemit. Trujillo, please do. Because emails. All right, that is one piece of evidence, but what I am looking for, what I am looking to see, is a rock-solid connection between Jack and Q and Jack and Thomas. You know? That is what I am looking to see. Tafoyevsky agrees. Well, like in a way that, you can check it out, I can put out the evidence. Because like, I don't want to try to, I don't feel the need to try to convince you. Cicada QA858TS Bernie 4 Eversox 72 seconds. True hello, you do not need to persuade me, you can just show me the evidence and I can draw my own conclusions. Tafoyevsky, hold on, let me look for the Defango video. True hello, what time is it there for you there? I'm just curious. Tafoyevsky, it is 5 a.m. True hello, 5 in the morning? Tafoyevsky, yeah. True hello, oh, bro. You need to get some sleep, man. Tafoyevsky, haha. Thomas is not the only thing that is going on. We've been busy. I'm going to send a paste bin on Twitter or in Zoom chat. We are talking in Zoom, which is why we enjoy this transcript and audio file rather than a gisted transcript. True hello, in Twitter please. Yeah, Tafoyevsky, okay. If you can send me, I can send you the email that Thomas sent to me, that same email. True hello, okay. Okay. There it is. Tafoyevsky, can you please type again your email? True hello, sure. Just a moment here. There you go. So this is dated April 1st, 2018? Tafoyevsky, sorry, can you repeat? True hello, this is dated April 1st, 2018. It does not escape me that this is April Fool's Day. Tafoyevsky. Yes, Trujillo, who is? Tafoyevsky, excuse me? Trujillo, who is Janice Matto? Her email is in the Defango paste bin. QCA858TS equals QANYO.NDeniseMatto. March 27, 2018. Tafoy, actually she has a YouTube channel that is called Truth Convoy. Googling Ms. Matto's name brings up this gem from the Dallas Police Department on Facebook. The second link when her name is Googled, apparently a post by Dwayne Holloway of Dallas PD. Denise Matto, Dallas PD blue check mark, no Dwayne Holloway, August 17, 2019. Except that Ms. Matto reportedly called Dallas PD and confirmed, she says, that no Officer Holloway is employed by that department. On August 17, Ms. Jacqueline Weaver commented on this article, page bottom, stating that Ms. Matto was apparently the victim of someone impersonating a police officer. Clicking on Mr. Holloway's name reveals that he is a website owner, video gamer and devoted son/brother from America in the city of Albany, and not a police officer at all. My guess is that Mr. Holloway is an activist, and he somehow prevailed on the Dallas PD to post his expose of Denise Matto's heinous trafficking in handmade quilts, funded through PayPal and a GoFundMe page. The quilts look nice, and she makes one per month. I intend to buy one, if I can coordinate the logistics of shipping it to Bangkok. Thai Customs imposes heavy import duties, as they want expatriates to purchase products made in the kingdom. Ms. Matto, naturally, is displeased to be called a scammer on the Dallas Police Department Facebook page, blue check marked, no less. In her critique of this interview, which she says lies about many things, she calls me a leftist, suggests that I am a Mossad stooge, and later, concludes that I am Peruvian. You cannot make things like this up. At the 35:13 timestamp in her video, Truth Convoy, my daily half hour double August 14, 2019. VR to Steve Trujillo, QAnon, Lestat, Cicada, YouTube, August 16, 2019. Ms. Matto declares, I make no apologies for my anti-Semitism, I earned every bit of it. The kindly grandma's steel spine is on full display as she rants against damned Jews. Unfortunately, I am not Jewish except in spirit. After claiming that we are afraid to talk to her, she cites Lift the Veil's Nathan Stolpman, another Jew in the mix. Then Ms. Matto shocks me, saying this is a good article. It's got a lot of stuff in it, but like I said, grain of salt, grain of salt. I thank her for her praise, but I enjoin all readers to remember that this interview captures the statements of Arturo Tafoyevsky. I merely comment on his words. After she criticizes Mr. Tafoyevsky because he is not American, he is Mexican, she errs when she condemns me, this guy Trujillo, is not American. I regret to correct Ms. Matto, but I am American born and bred, of Spanish descent, and a veteran. She complains that Mr. Tafoyevsky and I believe that the Dallas PD puts up smear pages on people who've never been anywhere near Dallas. This is actually a legit indictment. I should know better. Something about the Dallas PD Facebook page struck me, which may be why I included a screenshot of it in the first place. Ms. Matto is correct when she says that no American police department would be allowed to post materials like this. I am sure that she will get to the bottom of it. For my part, I apologize to Ms. Matto for publishing it. In my comment response below, I advised Ms. Weaver that Ms. Matto is not a focus of my investigations, and indeed she is not. I do not plan to investigate her trafficking in handmade quilts, despite her emphatic condemnation that Mr. Tafoyevsky and I are not Americans. We are in fact both Americans. Somos Americanos, Ms. Matto. Mexico is in North America. Tafoyevsky, she is a little I can say. Like, affected. Like, she has some psychological problems, but you can talk with her. She lost a daughter, and I think that it affected her. You send me